Proof of work or proof of stake. These are the two most common algorithm models used by blockchains to reach consensus on a decentralized network. This is a critical component to what makes blockchain technology so special. But what does it all mean? In this episode, you're going to learn how proof of work functions, how it differs from proof of stake, and how proof of stake works. Let's get to it. The Bitcoin protocol has been copied, modified, scrapped for parts, and totally reimagined by developers all over the world who really admire blockchain and cryptocurrency but want to see the functions of Bitcoin improve a little. But if Bitcoin is so great, why bother changing it? As the crypto community has grown and changed over the last 10 years, so have the ideas around the technology itself. Since Bitcoin is open source, anyone is free to copy it, change it, and modify it to their heart's content. One of the most common changes to the Bitcoin protocol is the way the coins can be mined. Proof of work is what Bitcoin uses. It refers to the fact that transactions in the blockchain are validated from the proof that miners did the work to mine that Bitcoin using their mining equipment. When a miner has more power to dedicate to the network, that means that they can validate more transactions and mine more coins. More power equals more coins for the miner. Proof of stake is when transactions are validated by people who are holding coins and have their wallets connected to the network. The people holding the coins are effectively doing the job miners would do, but in a different way, and they are the ones that reap the rewards provided by the network's transaction fees. With proof of stake, the more coins you hold, the more coins you make. Having more coins equals more coins. So which one is better? This is one of the hottest debates in the crypto community, with more than a few players on each side. But proof of stake has some pretty influential and famous fans, like Vitalik Buterin, the founder of Ethereum. Vitalik has been very vocal in the last year on his plans to move Ethereum to a proof of stake ecosystem, citing the amount of energy consumption the proof of work protocol requires as one of the key reasons. Cointelegraph cited in October 2017 that the average Bitcoin mining consumption was 288 megawatts daily. According to DigiEconomist, a single Bitcoin transaction consumes enough electricity to power over 13 houses in the US. That's insane. In comparison, proof of stake is much more energy efficient, which makes it a great alternative for crypto mining's woes. Ethereum plans to reduce energy consumption of its network by over 99% just by moving from proof of work to proof of stake. On top of that, proof of stake provides rewards for people who hold coins and keep their wallets connected to the network. You'll keep a real-time copy of the blockchain on your computer and receive a tiny portion of all transaction fees acquired while you're connected to the network. The amount you receive is relative to the amount of coins you have in your wallet. Remember, more coins equals more coins. With proof of work, you only make more coins when you have more power. And you need a lot more power to make a lot more coins. So, it pays to go with proof of stake, and not just for a handful of wealthy miners. These are some of the reasons why many projects like PIVX have incorporated proof of stake into their code. Remember, PIVX is the only privacy coin on the market that offers both proof of stake and privacy. PIVX continues to have one of the most active and dedicated tech teams in the entire proof of stake space, with a particular focus on ZPoS and privacy protocols. PIVX stands for Private Instant Verified Transaction and is a community-centric cryptocurrency with a focus on decentralization and real-world use. For more information, visit www.pivx.org. Come and see us in Discord. Thanks for watching, and until next time, peace, love, and PIV.